Anacondas, the giant snakes of the Amazon, hold the title of the largest snakes on Earth. These powerful predators can take down massive prey like goats, wild pigs, and even crocodiles with sheer strength and an unhinging jaw. But if they can swallow such massive creatures, what about a human? Could an anaconda actually eat you? Would you survive inside? And just how possible is it? Anacondas are massive snakes that can reach up to 30 feet long and weigh over 500 pounds, which is about the size of a grand piano in weight. Unlike venomous snakes that rely on fangs and venom, the anaconda uses pure muscle. These snakes strike with lightning speed, coiling around its prey and squeezing tighter with every breath, which means the more the victim struggles, the stronger the grip becomes. So, if an anaconda were to swallow you, it would use the same brutal tactics it applies to its usual prey. It would coil its powerful body around you, squeezing tighter with every passing second, draining your strength until you could no longer struggle. Once you're completely subdued, the real nightmare begins. With a jaw designed for extreme flexibility, the anaconda would slowly start swallowing you whole. Unlike human jaws, which are limited by bone, a snake's mouth can stretch up to 4 times the width of its head because of their special ligaments. This adaptation allows it to consume animals far larger than its own head. However, swallowing a fully grown human wouldn't be easy. Your broad shoulders would be a major obstacle, forcing the snake to exert even more effort to expand its jaws and maneuver your body into its throat. But once past that point, the anaconda's powerful throat muscles would do the rest, pulling you deeper, inch by inch, on a one-way trip into darkness. Once inside the anaconda, the environment is anything but hospitable. Oxygen quickly runs out, leaving nothing but an airless, suffocating chamber. The temperature soars past 100 degrees Fahrenheit, creating a sauna-like heat perfect for digestion. But the true horror lies in the snake's potent digestive enzymes and stomach acids. These acids, primarily hydrochloric acid and powerful proteolytic enzymes, break down flesh, muscle, and even bone over time. Within hours, skin, hair, and clothing begin to dissolve, melting away under the relentless effects of gastric juices. The process is slow yet incredibly efficient, with digestion taking days to weeks, depending on the meal size. Once an anaconda has swallowed its prey, escape is virtually impossible. By the time you're inside the snake, you'd already be unconscious due to lack of oxygen. Even if you somehow had a knife, the snake's muscular stomach walls would be too tight, making movement impossible. Once an anaconda commits to swallowing something, it doesn't stop. Its throat muscles continuously push food down, ensuring nothing comes back up, unless the snake itself decides otherwise through regurgitation, a defensive reaction that allows the snake to expel food it cannot properly digest. While anacondas have been known to swallow prey up to half their body weight, a fully grown human would present a unique challenge. Broad shoulders and rigid limbs could make swallowing difficult, forcing the snake to expand its jaws to extreme limits. Even if successfully swallowed, the bulk and density of a human body could delay digestion, increasing the risk of the snake rejecting the meal entirely. While they have the power to take down massive animals, actual attacks on people are incredibly rare. In reality, these giant snakes prefer to stay hidden in their natural habitat, avoiding humans whenever possible. More than a terrifying predator, the anaconda is a misunderstood marvel of nature, one that commands respect rather than fear. Thanks for diving into the terrifying question: what if you were swallowed by an anaconda? If you enjoyed exploring interesting stories with us, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. What topics do you want us to dive into next? Let us know in the comments. Join us as we get animated about science here at Animated Science.